already knew there was going to be multiplayer. Of course there's going to be multiplayer. But with Resistance 3, it was like, what form is it going to take? Why the decision to go more intimate here for R3?
The story that we're trying to tell, the theme of the game, really is a lot more personal. It's not giant army on giant army. The most important thing is just to make the gameplay more fun. And we really were trying to make it so players have more choice and can play the game they want to play. We just started sort of whittling down the player count and trying to find that sweet spot for our game and what works for the pacing of our game and what works for sort of map sizes and all those things. And 8-on-8 ended up just being that perfect sweet spot.
Resistance 2, there were three major classes you would be using, especially when you were talking about the co-op, but a lot of that carried over. There's a lot more different choices, a lot more different loadouts. So talk about customization and individually with your particular character and the persistence as well.
It's more of a custom progression. It's instead of having explicit classes that you have to play as, we have abilities that enable you to pick and choose and kind of work your way through. You know, I'm a medic, and now I have to work my way up through medic, but we give you abilities to heal people, but you could be a sniper and do that. You can be whatever playstyle you want. You can cater towards that playstyle. So we have the addition of abilities that are more stat buff kind of things that are passive. So you get to choose from a couple of those, and you'll earn XP, and you'll purchase those, you'll upgrade those. And then you also have the active ones that are triggerable on the D-pad during the course of the game. They're temporary. And those are a lot more sort of extreme and game-changing.
Single player taking place in America, multiplayer taking place abroad. What other side of the story we're seeing?
It's always been kind of a game that was global. But with Resistance 3, as the story developed, it was pretty clear that we wanted to continue Joseph Capelli's story. And that would mean necessitating that it takes place in America. But we wanted to keep some of that epic story, global storytelling element. So the multiplayer maps do take place around the world. And when you're in single player, you'll hear radio messages, kind of the human radio network, talking about battles that are going on in those locations. So it's just a way of kind of like bringing back the idea that this is a global struggle.